Greetings, St. Isaac's family. In this time of confinement, we want to continue to minister to you from a distance. They tell us to spend the next 2 weeks alone, but for those who have faith, we're never alone, are we? God is with us. Around Christmas time, we're always reminded in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 1, verse 23, "Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel," which means God with us. Paintings and even movies that recreate the scene of this virgin, Mary, receiving the news, always show her home alone when the angel Gabriel appears, much as we are right now. It's generally thought she was about 14 or 15 when this happened. I've sometimes asked groups of teens to imagine if it happened today. A normal teen in 2020 might have their headphones on, maybe, be busy texting on the phone, maybe watching YouTube or playing video games. They may be too busy to hear the angel trying to get their attention. Well, in usual times, we're all super busy too, aren't we? Trying to find time for God can be hard, but it's in the still quiet moments we can really find God. Psalm 46 says, "Be still and know that I am God." In the life of the prophet Elijah, there's a story I like in the first book of Kings, chapter 19, verses 11 to 13. If you've got a Bible handy, go open it and read it with me. The first book of Kings is found in the first quarter of the Bible, after the books of Samuel. By the way, this will be the first reading at Mass on Sunday, August the 9th this year, so hopefully we're back together at Mass then. Here we go, you ready? "At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, 'Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by.' A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave." I've always loved this scene. Yesterday, I saw a report from Times Square, where all the usual noise and crowds have given way to emptiness and silence. In modern times, most of us are drawn to the big noise and the action, aren't we? But the Lord was not in the wind, not in the earthquake or the fire. He was in the small, still voice. So in your self-isolation, think of it not as a punishment or a burden, but as an invitation to meet with the Lord. We, the staff of St. Isaac's, will all be praying for you. And remember, faith, not fear.
Not in the raging storm do you speak to me. Not in the earthquake, Lord, do you speak to me. Go out and meet the presence of the Lord. Go out and meet the presence of the Lord. Not in the raging storm do you speak to me. Not in the fire, Lord, do you speak to me. Go out and meet the presence of the Lord. Go out and be the presence of the Lord. Go out to him, go out and meet the presence of the Lord. Go out and be the presence of the Lord. Go out to him, not in the raging storm to you. Speak to me, but in the gentle whisper you